7.
You are? I thought you were older than 7. You're 7? Wow. You're tall for 7. Of course, I'm short, so.
How about you, Molly? How old are you?
I'm 9.
You're 9. And you guys don't have to say how old you are. I won't say how old I am, okay? But you're probably all younger than me. Anyway.
I'm not.
Tell me, how did you get into this? Obviously, you're Irish, right?
Right. Most of our dancers are Irish, but we do have some dancers that are not Irish.
Really? Tell me about the group.
Here we are with Ardon Academy of Irish Dance, and our main offices or classes are in Detroit, but we have a satellite in Grand Rapids here.
Cool.
And Teresa comes in from Granham.
Spring Lake area.
Spring Lake.
But you actually live here, Darcy?
We actually live in Grand Rapids.
You do?
We come out here to Muskegon,
We
have dancers from Muskegon, Cadillac, Holland, all over. They come to Grand Rapids for dancing.
So how long have you been in this?
I've been associated with Irish dancing for like over 25 years.
And what got you into it? Is it just your heritage?
Yeah, it was strictly our heritage, yes.
And what about you?
Basically, I saw the show Riverdance and I was enthralled, and so I sought out the local school, and I've been dancing and competing for 11 years now.
And what about the little guys? How did we get them into it? How long have they been dancing?
My mom, that's Darcy. She said, you got to do Irish dance.
It's part of our heritage. These are my sons, but most of the kids have siblings that they want to, that, you know, are dancing, but a lot of them have the whole family doing it. It's part of our heritage, and we want to carry that on.
Is it hard to learn to do? How long did it take you to become skilled?
It's pretty easy. The basics are somewhat simple, but then once you progress to higher levels, it gets increasingly difficult.
Tell me a little bit about the kinds of dances that you do.
Well, we have hard shoe dances, which have the hard shoes with the steel tips, and they make noise. Mm-hmm. And then the soft shoe dances, which are more light and feathery and beautiful. Mm-hmm. And as you progress, you know, they take a certain amount of athleticism that you have to train for and become more skilled at. Practice a lot.
They do jigs and reels. Yeah, these are the boys' soft shoes that he has on here. Uh-huh. But their shoes are a little different from the girls. The girls have an all soft shoe. They have a hard shoe and a soft shoe. But it's jigs and reels, hornpipes, and treble reels.
Oh, that's excellent. Now, it's quite a workout, huh?
Very much so.
It seems like it would be very, that's why you're all in such great shape.
Well, we have a lot of young dancers that do it for their heritage and because they love the style of dance. And then we have a lot of adults that want to celebrate their heritage but do it more for exercise.
That was actually going to be my next question, is what is the age range? Is it all ages?
Honestly, going younger than 3 is a little difficult. So we take usually dancers from 5 all the way up to 70 to 80 years old.
No kidding. And do they divide them into classes? Like, do you have kids classes, or are you all in the same group but just measured on your, you know?
Usually there's only 1-2 adults in each class, so they do dance with the children. But as she says, as the dances progress, the adults kind of fall back a little bit and they go into other classes because it gets so difficult that it's difficult for the adults to pick up.
Do you perform all over West Michigan?
Yes, we do.
Really?
West Michigan, yes.
Oh, very cool.
And they compete all year round. So they compete Midwest. We travel all over the Midwest to compete.
So the competing, now that must be fun, huh? Have you guys won any, like, trophies and stuff?
Yeah. Well, Teresa's our champion dancer.
All right.
And Molly's in prize winner, and Owen's in our beginner to novice level.
Well, how cool is that? These are the whiz kids
And they do win trophies, and they do win medals. So it is a huge honor, and that's what gets them into their open dresses, which we'll be in a little bit later tonight if you're able to stay around for that.
Oh, absolutely. Now, other than that, do you guys, like, are you into Irish food? Are you into the whole culture? Thing.
Most of our dancers do take instruments. They particularly do dance, but we do have some that are getting in, like my children will be getting into the Irish instruments also, the boron and the accordion and the fiddle. And so they do try to celebrate all year round, but everyone does celebrate the food also. So they make different dishes such as the potato and leek soup,
awesome.
And we do all corned beef and hash,
and
all that.
Oh yeah,
stuff.
We love corned beef.
It's wonderful. Boiled ham, all that.
If somebody's interested in getting involved or in finding out where you're performing next or anything about the competitions, what do they do? What website do they go
to? They could go to our website, and it's Ardon Academy of Irish Dance, and they can go on our website and check out our school and all the information they would need to join Irish dancing.
Fantastic. And do you have a phone number we could also put up right now?
Right now you could call my house. It would be 616-464-3290.
Excellent. And so they can start out as beginners, right? You don't have to come with any skills.
That's correct. That's right.
How
entry
cool
level.
Is that?
Yeah,
that's
and
amazing.
That'll be in September. We're taking students in September, so that's when they would start.
Fantastic. Okay. Well, I'd like to thank all of you guys.
Thank you.
www.ardon.com.
You got it, buddy. This is the advertisement right here. Thank you very much.
Thank
and we're
going
to catch some of the dancing now.
All right, great. Thank you so much. We'll look forward to it.
Exhaust Specialties, from trucks and cars to street rods and Model Ts, both foreign and domestic. Exhaust Specialties now includes brakes, shocks, suspension work, and minor engine repair. They use only heavy gauge stainless and aluminum pipe. They also feature custom duals as well as a selection of lubes, oils, and filters, and other auto parts. Exhaust Specialties located at 5401 Apple Avenue in Muskegon.
Kelvin's Nails and Spa, complete professional nail care services. Acrylic nails, gel nails, fills, American and French manicures and pedicures. Paraffin treatments, airbrush designs. Kelvin's also offers permanent makeup, waxing, eyelash extensions, facials, and massage.
The Glenside and Northside Pubs, from sandwiches, burgers, and Mexican food to starters, salads, soups, and desserts, not to mention their specialty pizzas like Hawaiian, vegetarian, chicken Alfredo, and of course their grand finale. It's the Glenside and Northside Pubs.
The House of Hobbies, where they put the joy back in toy, offering remote control cars, boats, and airplanes, Pinewood Derby and slot car accessories, model trains and layout materials, anything from imitation grass and ballast to locomotives, boxcars, and cabooses. The House of Hobbies features science experiment kits and educational materials. They also carry a wide variety of models and model making equipment, specializing in getting what you want, including paint, brass, balsa wood, glue, and decals. It's the House of Hobbies, 962 West Broadway Avenue in Roosevelt Park.
Say yes to Nexus. I did.
Say yes to Nexus.
Say yes to Nexus.
Say yes to Nexus.
Say yes to Nexus. I did.
Say yes to Nexus.
Get connected.
We did.
Waters Law Office is located at 1725 Peck Street in Muskegon, specializing in Social Security, SSI disability, and personal injury. We offer a free interview and no fee unless we win. Waters Law Offices, we fight for you.